shape of the eye, their color of the hair, which we, whenever a baby is born, we compare it with either the mother or the father. The characters that we see externally, we are talking about those only, plus the inherent characters also, which we cannot see. So the inheritance is a process of passing down the characters, that is the genes, from one parent to the other. Then what is the meaning of variation? There is, now whenever these characters are being passed, we see the outcome or the result is not exactly the same. What happens, the degree of difference of these, the degree of difference of these characters is known as variation. So, as I told you, the hair might be curly. A mother's hair is more curly, and the daughter's hair might also be curly, but there is a degree of difference. The same curliness is not there. So, we call it as variation. Or it may so happen that the color might be very different. The color of the one may be absolutely black, the other might be brown. So, these are some of the degree of differences. Now the entire study, it was very well known from the around 18th century or prior to that. The people had some idea that these characters are generally are passed down sexually. But in-depth knowledge was not there. It was Mendel was the first person. He had researched on Pisum sativum. Pisum sativum, it is the pea plant. That is the pea plant. And he had understood or gave us some idea regarding the passing of something from one parent, from the parent to the offspring, which is causing all these variations. Now, there were a lot of problems he faced in his life. The first thing is that he was himself a mathematician. Now, whatever study he did, the biological society at that time was not able to accept that, his theory. Secondly, during those times, his work, the publication was not widespread. So, whatever was published by him, it was in a limited area. It never reached the entire world. Now there were a number of hindrances in his work. These were some, and later, after he died, later around 16 years later, what happened? Three scientists had studied his work, and his work, after that, it became famous. Now we have to remember what was his work. We have to study that. That is his work on Pisum sativum. What are the characters he had chosen? Why did he choose? He was quite lucky in choosing the pea plant. So we have to understand that also. Now, coming to the next part, that is the reasons for his not being successful. This we have to write or remember. Sometimes a small question like 1 mark question or 2 mark question is often asked as to give reasons for not being successful at that time. The first one I told you, it is publishing was not widespread. That means whatever work he had done, it was not spread very widely. The second was biologists. The biologists at that time, they did not recognize his work. Did not recognize his work. And the third one is, he had used a term which he often used this term as factor. a medium height plant or nothing of that sort. So he was quite lucky in choosing a pea plant. Now, what were the features of the pea plant that he had taken? He had chosen seven characteristics of pea plant. This is the first one, first point. The second one was the lifespan. The lifespan of pea plant is 3 to 4 weeks. So what does it mean? It means that within a month he is able to get the seeds, replant them and again get seeds. So the result in front of him was very quick. If he had chosen maybe some other plant which had taken a year or two to produce the result, his work would have remained incomplete. Now the other things, that is the sample size that he collected, the seeds which he collected, samples collected were large in number. Okay, so he did not work with only a few seeds. He collected number, he planted them again. And the fourth point, which is very important, a pea plant can be self-pollinated. It undergoes self-pollination and cross-pollination as well. So what is it? First he allowed the pea plants to self-pollinate them. And then cross-pollination is a factor which can be done by humans also. So we have studied in the previous chapter, chapter number 2, how cross-pollination can be done. So cross-pollination was one of the advantage which he had for pea plant. A pea plant has both self-pollinating feature as well as cross-pollinate. So whenever he needed to cross-pollinate, he would do it himself. The next point, that contrasting the lifespan also we have discussed. So these were some of the very important features, or he was quite lucky, you can say, that when he had chosen the pea plant. The fifth one I can also mention here, that there was no link. The genes were not linked. We will study about this linked genes in the next chapter. He was lucky because if there is a linked gene, the chances of variation, the frequency of variation increases, or if it is unlinked, then the crossing over, if it is linked, crossing over doesn't take place. We will study about this. But what happens if there is contrasting characters? I told you he took only tall and dwarf. There was nothing in between. That happens only when the genes are linked. Okay. The reason for his success, we have to remember, this is sometimes asked as to why he chose the pea plant. Then also the answers will be these. Because he had seen these characteristics and he could do cross-pollination with them. And whatever samples he collected, they were all in large number. So ultimately, whatever result he gave, his result was that after doing all these experiments, he said that factors passed down from one generation to another. At that time, the word gene was not used. So people did not have the idea. He himself did not have the idea. Like chromosome, inside the chromosome, we can call a part as gene, which is responsible for casting part. That is, if you see here, the seed shape round, wrinkled. Seed color yellow, green, contrasting. Remember, there is no intermediate. Yellow and green. There is either the seed was yellow or it was green. Now, all these seven contrasting characters. The third one was flower color. It is either violet or sometimes it is written as purple or white. Pod shape, it is full or constricted. Pod color, green and yellow. Flower position, it is axial or terminal. Then the stem height, that is tall and dwarf. Learn the seven characters, plus you have to learn the dominant and recessive. After learning the traits, now let me make one thing clear here. Every time you all get confused, that is the word trait. What is the meaning of the word trait? Trait means height. It is or flower color or seed color. So these are traits. Okay, now a trait can has two parts, that is it is either dominant or recessive. A trait, like if I am talking about a trait or a character, let's take the trait height. Height is a trait. Now height is of two types. One is tall, another is dwarf. Okay. Now tall is represented by a gene. Now suppose this is the chromosome, one of the chromosome of the pea plant, and here is the gene for tall. And I am mentioning it as T. T stands for tall. In the other chromosome, this portion at the same position, there is the allele. This is the allele. Now this can be, then the second chromosome, it can be the same gene. So if it is same, then we are writing capital T. If the sequence of the genes are little different, but it is still dominant, or rather it may become recessive. So what happens? Suppose you have another pea plant which is also showing T. This is T and here it is small t. Because here the gene is different, but it is the gene of the tallness, that is it is the trait. So what happens? So this is also tall, this is also tall, whereas if this is another pea plant number one, this is two, and this is the third pea plant, where the same place, same chromosome, we have a gene for tallness. But it is different and both are same, then we call it as dwarf. Now this idea, please make sure that you have this idea. This is a previous idea that you already have, and it is you have studied in class 9 about the term allele. What is an allele? Alleles are the two parts of the same gene. Suppose this is the gene for tall. Then what happens? I have told you that chromosome. If you remember the chromosome structure, we had drawn structures and we had given the nitrogenous bases in this way. Isn't it? So I had written A, T, T, C. Suppose this much, only this much, A, T, T, C, A, C, T. This much is responsible for tall. And what dominant character and this is recessive, and so the plant is not tall, now it is dwarf. And time and again I keep on telling you, if you don't have this idea clear, you will be having difficulty in solving the monohybrid process and the dihybrid process. Please get used to the terms trait, gene, allele. These terms are extremely important. Go through your previous knowledge, that is, what is a gene, what is an allele, what is a trait. So please understand them carefully so that we can proceed with the chapter easily. Next we will do what are the experiments that Mendel